Alright, so here's the batteries connected in sequence, and you got 60 volts. You got your two main leads here, positive, negative. Hi, by the way. Anyway, so this scooter runs on 60 volts. So you got your 412 volt lead acid batteries here, with the fifth one down behind here, where your feet go, just behind that wall. So I'm just documenting this so I don't forget how to put them back in. So this one is negative facing out, positive facing out. And the fifth battery is connected positive on this side with negative on this side. And to take out the trunk piece, it's 10 metric. You got your two here for the top part, and then your two bottom ones go here and here. Please forgive the sound quality if it's not that good. I've repaired this camera like 20 times because I keep dropping the goddamn thing. So bear with me. Since I was working with tweezers to try and put the camera back together, I didn't put back in the pop filter, so forgive if there's any wind noises in that. But because we live here in Canada, where it gets super cold, these batteries will freeze. And my garden shed is not insulated enough to stop them from freezing. Well, yeah, this is my electronic scooter. Three-wheeler. Eco thing. You know. Pretty nice mags. Yeah. Disc brakes in the front. I got a little bit of rust to take care of next spring. Oh, well. That's no problem. Yeah, that's some damage. My friend that I bought this off of, he built himself a little shed to store it, and he put the frame to hold the front tire in a bit too short, so it broke the front fender. I don't care. It builds, it adds character, you know? It suits me, yeah. And this is your radio. Please, because you can play MP3s, you connect a USB to it, you know, or you put an SD card. I think that's an SD card slot. Looks like one. Anyway, you can play MP3s. That's your antenna. This is my external antenna that I made, because with the electronic mortar, which is here, it makes a lot of interference on the FM band. And you got your main breaker. Always remember to shut this off before you start disconnecting your batteries, because you don't want to ground the batteries. Otherwise you end up with a fire, and then you have to replace these wires. Which I have had to do on a previous scooter. At least this one, the axle here, doesn't leak. My old one did. So it wasn't usable anymore. So I put it out for garbage, and a couple people took it, and next thing I know, I see the neighbor across the street has it. So, obviously they rebuilt it. Good for them. Reason why I'm taking these batteries out is because, like I said before, it gets very cold here. So, I'm just documenting this for myself so I know exactly how to put them back in. Because this is the first time I'm going to be taking them all out and leaving them out for the season. Right now, it's November 12th, I believe. Sunday, yeah, November 12th. So yeah, I'm going to be taking these out so they don't freeze, and then one by one I'll put them on trickle charge to keep them topped off, because at 80 some odd bucks each, it's getting a little expensive to replace batteries every year. So these ones I want to try and save. And as you can see, they're nice and kind, well, except for my dirty fingers where they touched. Anyway, so that's it. So there's my two main leads here. Positive from the fifth battery and negative there. So now I gotta take this off, which is also 10 metric, which you can see right there. So you take this frame off, scoot it to the side. And I believe these bolts here, what I like about these new batteries is they're bolts and not Phillips head screws. Come on, where's that tool? I put it in my other pocket. Possibly. Nope. Can't find it. Ah, I use the key. Key works too. I hate these fucking caps. See, it's so cold, these are so stiff. Anywho, that's the lowdown. So, two main leads. Positive right, left-hand side. Negative for the fifth battery. It is on the right. So, I know which direction to put the batteries back in. Anywho, that's all for now. Hope you enjoyed the video. Like I said, sorry about the sound quality. This camera is about on its last legs. I have a secondary camera, but it's still in the box, and I don't really want to take it out if I don't have to damage it, because I'm very, rough with my equipment. So, anywho, yeah, so that's my documentation. Hope you enjoyed the video. Bye.